ice cold towel.
They got them here too.
It's been a while since I've done a press conference.
Actually, Pan Am has them.
Thank you.
my left, see if I can get a better shot down here. Yeah. That's an arcpoon.
Thank you.
That the national strength of a nation lies in the hearts and spirits of its people. I salute each of you, delegates, contestants, and officers. God bless you all, and thank you for the invitation.
To show our appreciation for your interest and dedication to young people in the vocational industrial clubs of America. The plaque is presented to General Charles Van Duke in appreciation for participation in the first general session, 1983, NLC, USSO, Louisville, Kentucky.
Thank you. In his State of the Union address last year, our Commander-in-Chief expressed his willingness to match the success of this nation can be traced to the willingness of the people to respond to its national leadership. As we gather to tell the world of our pride in our country, its leadership. His concern for our future is genuine, and his presence here today will inspire all who see and hear him. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much, Rick. And what a pleasure it is for me to be with you today in Kentucky to hold its annual National Leadership Conference and United States Skill Olympics. You represent this nature's future.
You are here today to reaffirm my personal commitment. I'm determined to see that you get all three.
America's tradesmen and tradesmen and women are the pistons that drive the engine of our economy. This country was built with the sweat formed this continent into one of the wonders of the modern world. We're a nation of people who believe it's not enough to be good. You've got to be good at something. Here a book ends. We do need to remind ourselves where greatness comes from. Each spenders and the big taxers in the Congress won't steal it from you. Of America. You have a right to pursue careers of your choice and can take pride in the fact that America needs
every VICA member, a winner already. First on the, made the first football team at Eureka College, made the classrooms, those dim bulbs that never seem to be bright enough when it's nighttime. And I had never gone into a game in my life that I hadn't said a prayer. But I never would have said it to those guys around me. Every fellow in that room had developed, did the same thing. And then a question came from the coach. Now I know what I'd figured out for myself should be a prayer. You can't ask to win, because the Lord's got to be on everybody's side. But there are things you can ask, and one by one, I heard home winners, no matter just how it comes out. As a matter of fact, you're winners, or you wouldn't even be competing.
Mr. President, Mr. President, we appreciate your appearance and your support here today, and we assure you that the 275,000 members of VICA
activity, as you continue to lead our nation, we hope you will remember that the working men and women of America will always be this nation's greatest asset. We ask that you accept this token of our appreciation as a symbol of our willingness to work together. This hard hat should remind you that VICA members are America's new professionals, and under your leadership, we will keep America first. Thank you.
Thank you all
very much.
I'm very proud to have you. Thank you.
Okay.